we declare the food fit for royal consumption.
Oh. It's fit, all right. It was supposed to be fit for my family.
What?
With all due respect, Your Majesty, Lord Darnley takes it upon himself to go around the lowlands and the peasants taking their food for himself. You're nothing more than a rabbit going around these lands, spreading yourself and taking other people's food.
Arrest
this man!
No, he's not going to explain. He's going to he's taking up a lot of our very important time.
If you didn't, you know, stampede on our fun, because we are in a bit of a fun here. Do you mind?
Scots would kind of like to call these toothpicks, if you will. However, rapiers are a very dangerous weapon. They were used more in duels, more in friendly duels, sometimes not so friendly. However, the biggest difference is a person who could wield a rapier was the most accurate marksman with a sword. Reason being is because it is so light, it was made to put into any portion of the body they wanted to. Because of its long, slender bill, they could stab a person at a great distance wherever they wanted to. It was most effective against a person wearing chainmail. Because of the chainmail, usually wouldn't be affected by normal blades, but since it is so long and slender, it split them through.
Rohan!
Wait! Weren't you dead? I thought I killed you!
and missed, almost. Got a little bit of flesh wound, but I'll live. But now you will die.
All right.
Oh! Oh, misfire.
What? What?
Guess I have also.
Sorry.
You never liked this man in the first place. Why don't you take care of him?
Wait. Oh. Oh. No!
Ladies and gentlemen, we'll have more feats of strength and agility out on the fields, as our Highland Warriors will also be doing that Saturday and Sunday out here on the field. So we hope that you'll come and see them.
A Norse ship that takes on water, only to be saved by a scot. And ships clearly scorned from Norse. Aye. They're native Scottish bloods with little more than gutted cattle. At least at Cowhides we know where the holes are.
Oh.
And here I thought that the Scots only have sheep free from them.
Right?
Well, let's see if a Norseman flees or if he just stands and bleeds.
All right.
Life as well. Great
right
to your
guards.
Present these men, soon to give their vows before God and peers, to be worthy of knighthood. To the order of the Priory of the Knights of the Red Dragon. So chosen and ordered, my fellow knights and warriors, and sanctioned by Warlord and Grandmaster Dermot Campbell.
I like supporting this guy because he's a good man. I've known him for what, 4 or 5 years now? 5 years now, just before Campbell stole them from us. And, but he's doing better here. He's enjoying himself,
I know
him.
That.
And he's that, I'm sure. I'll be glad to shake his hand when he is, or hug him when he's a knight. And I hope he can keep going longer and longer. And in my guild, I've been yelling, he stays for tear down and set up.
I saw the young Rohan McKee come swaggering with his sword. He did assess his ground and really seemed quite bored. But soon he would brace himself, and little he could afford to smugly stand there arrogant, the young McKee lad and his sword. Dermot Campbell and James McDonald, Liam McMillan and McLeod, an Irishman named Donlan and Brandu. They were mighty and proud. So the young McKee did pull steel, and his sword did glint in the sun. And many were the battles he fought. But it wasn't enemies he sought, but a clan and a family, by time and grace he bought. Just know, young McKee, that you are never too far from us. You are always in our thoughts and our hearts. Lots of love, lad, from all of us. Your light has been taken from us, but the shine of the memory remains as an example of a grand warrior and a good, good man. God's greatest gift is love, and you did bestow it on all of us. Thank you for your friendship. Thank you for the many good times and the laughter, always the laughter. And then the masses heard Freebird, and all was well in the land.
Caledonia has been everything I've ever had.